What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more Leonard Nimoy. That's right, we're going to listen to another tune by the one and only Nimoy. We're going to listen to another track that seems to have a direct connection to his persona as Spock. I think it was Kim was mentioning that he's had sort of a complicated relationship with the character outside of Star Trek, meaning I don't think he wanted to be typecast as Spock, the idea that it's the only thing for which he is ever recognized. But I think ultimately, over time, he came to embrace it and understand that the character is just so iconic that it will forever be linked to him and his legacy. So I enjoy like both sides of that. I enjoy not wanting to be seen singularly in terms of your acting and your artistic performance, but I do also understand that over time it's like, look, Star Trek is iconic. You know, whether you're a fan of different generations, you know, the original cast, Next Generation, so on, I think everyone who enjoys Star Trek will recognize that the character Spock and the performance of Leonard Nimoy, especially in some of the movies in particular, is just, you know, it is rightly legendary. So, in any case, we're going to listen to another tune with a direct connection to that, and it is highly illogical. Many people will know, you know, part of his character is that, you know, Vulcans are sort of relentlessly and unceasingly logical in the way they approach situations, and so ultimately he builds a lot of what he does around the logic of a given situation. And, you know, many of the scenes where they sort of go back and forth in the control room about what they need to do, he's the voice of reason. He's quite literally the voice of logic. So, you know, thinking about this tune, you know, one might be inclined to think that it might be a refrain or like a part of the chorus where, you know, he suggests maybe what humans do and that we're highly illogical, because again, that's part of what the dynamic of his character is, right? Like, he's working very closely with a human who is perhaps representative of the best that we do and also the most erratic or the most dangerous of what we do, because Kirk is like highly emotional and he's sort of like passionate. And so ultimately, it's a dynamic of logic meeting with passion, you know, in terms of what they decide to do in a given episode or film. So, yeah, maybe the fact that in that context, highly illogical often relates to humans and their actions, it makes me think that maybe that's where this tune will be going. But let's find out. This is Leonard Nimoy. The tune is Highly Illogical. And I forget what album this is. I thought when I first started reacting to some of the tunes in this folder that it was all the same album, but I'm not sure about that. Oh, okay, see, it does say here in the metadata, Spaced Out, so I suppose this is from an album or compilation called Spaced Out. I think it's a compilation. I think that's what someone said. But yeah, I think the material I have access to comes from a few different places, so in each case, you know, if someone knows, do shout it out. But here we go, Leonard Nimoy, Highly Illogical.
From far beyond the galaxies, I've journeyed to this place to study the behavior patterns of the human race. And I find them highly illogical.
Whoa.
Girl meets boy.
What?
They fall in love.
What?
She says he's everything she's dreamed of. But when they get married, before he's aware, she changes his habits, the way he combs his hair. She changes him to someone he's never been, and then complains he's not like other men. Now really, I find this most illogical. Take the case of your automobiles, greatest invention since man discovered wheels. Hydromatical drive, four on the floor, push-button windows, push-button doors, double-barrel carburetors rush you any place, but you never can find a parking space. Highly illogical. Take the case of modern man. He works all his
life, gives
like, what? All he can, saves all his money, works overtime, pinches every penny, banks every dime. All he can think about is money, but you know that he can't take it with him where he's going to go. Now I find that fascinatingly illogical. Now is the time to journey home to tell of what I've learned.
Or are you going to go back
My
to the Star
people,
Trek vibes now?
My people, have every right to be concerned. For in spite of computers and advanced psychology, behavior patterns are still a real. I predict the future of this earthly human race is that having made a mess of Earth, they'll move to outer space. Well, there goes the neighborhood.
That's hilarious.
Totally, completely, absolutely, irrevocably, vile, illogical.
It's just, like, insane brilliance. That's, like, Shatner-level insane brilliance. Like, number one, we're doing the Star Trek thing, and suddenly we go into this kind of groovy late 60s, early 70s, kind of, like, you know, quasi-hippie sort of vibes. And then it's, like, the narratives, the anecdotes he tells to elucidate or illuminate the degree to which humans are illogical are, like, ridiculous little stories. But, yeah, I mean, it's, like, I don't even know, like, how to begin unpacking that. Yeah, but I will say the comment about how we don't understand humanity because it's still too complex, basically it's true. Like, we have no predictive theory of history, of anthropology, of sociology in the way that, like, the hard, like, natural sciences allow for predictive theories, because the subjects, as Carl Sagan once said, are still too complex for us. So the idea that, like, trying to understand anthropology or human history to the same degree as either a formal logical discipline like mathematics or like an observational slash experimental hard science like chemistry or physics, it's just not the same thing. So yeah, it's perceptive, it's insane, and it's sort of brilliant. And again, that line about, like, well, eventually, you know, they're going to figure out how to leave Earth, because, you know, it's like the illogical behavior is so ridiculous, but then that's going to destroy the neighborhood. Oh, there goes the neighborhood. Might as well sell the house, you know, out by Uranus, which is actually the way you say that planet name. Nevertheless, let me know what you think. I will see you next time. Peace.